started with the okay. So we have done with the systematic position and the life that is the gametophytic structure. How is it? So how was the polytrichum plant? I told you that it was a miniature like plant showing the presence of the rhizome, an upright leafy shoot, presence of the leaves, and the leaves are spirally arranged and they are sessile and showing the presence of a midrib region and having the photosynthetic region, and the rhizoids, they are helping in anchoring the plant body to the soil and absorbing of the food material, that is absorbing of the minerals from the soil. And attached to the gametophyte is the sporophyte, which is developed after the reproduction process, that is after the fertilization. And the sporophyte is also dependent on the gametophyte. Next comes to the internal structure we studied about. So we talk about the development of the vascular tissues, that is the hydrome, leptome, okay, so which are the tissues equivalent to the xylem and the phloem, which were observed in the central cylinder of the transverse section of the rhizome. And also we talked about the aerial stem. Even in the aerial stem transverse section also, we came across the presence of hadrome and the leptome, which is surrounding the central opening, what we call it as the mantle. And in the leaves also, we studied about the presence of the lamellar tissue. You can see here, this is a lamellar tissue, which is very thick, forming the midrib region of the leaf, showing the photosynthetic nature or the photosynthetic tissue, performing the photosynthesis and having the sclerenchymatous tissue, which gives you the clarity of about the mechanical strength or the thickness of the leaf, and also the epidermal tissue and the terminal cells. So yesterday we begin with the reproduction. So we started with the vegetative reproduction, which is carried out with the help of a filamentous tissue or a filamentous plant body like structure we called as the protonema, which was developed from the spores. The spores which liberated from the sporophyte, those spores, they are undergoing germination and forming a filamentous like structure called as protonema. On this protonema, we have seen the development of the buds, what we call it as the apical buds. These buds, they help in the development of a new plant body. And not only that, we have also studied about the fragmentation, that is the older thallus or the older plant body. Upon the death or breaking of the any part of the plant body or the gametophyte, it will have the capacity to develop into an independent plant. So in the vegetative reproduction we studied yesterday. Now we'll go for the sexual reproduction. So when we talk about the sexual reproduction here, in the polytrichum plant is considered as a dioecious plant. So that means to say, the sexual organs are developed on two separate plants. That is anthra, it develops on a male plant, and the archegonia, they develop on a female plant. Fine. Now next, when we talk about the anthridial development or anthridial plant, so on the plant, you can see the development of anthridia at the terminal position of the aerial stem. The terminal position, that means on the tip of the main gametophyte, you can see the development of anthridia. And another important point is these anthridia, they are developed on or they are born in between the cluster of leaves. That means to say, it is a characteristic feature of polytrichum. That means the reproductive organ, that is the anthridia and the archegonia, they are getting surrounded by the cluster of leaves at the top or at the tip of the aerial stem. Now that cluster, we are calling it as the head region. Suppose if that leaves are surrounding the anthridia, then it is going to form the anthridial head. Suppose they are surrounding the archegonia, they are called as the archegonial head. So this is a very very good characteristic feature or a distinguishing point of the polytrichum. Okay, so we can see here the antheridia. You can see here these are the antheridia. Okay, the light colored structures, what you can see, they are the antheridia. So they are surrounded by a rosette of leaves. So these leaves which are surrounding the antheridia, we call them as perigonial leaves. Peri means surrounding, gonial means the reproductive organs. So the leaves, they're just surrounding, they're forming just like a flower-like structure. Okay, so they are called as the perigonial leaves. Now, these leaves, they are spirally arranged. Okay, they're completely surrounding the antheridia just for protection. Next, these antheridia, they are produced in groups. So we can see as many as 10 to 12 antheridia, they develop in this particular head. Now, these antheridia, they have a different antheridia groups. So in between the antheridia also, you can see certain scale leaves. That means the leaves which are just, we can call them as the hair-like, or they are the brown-colored structures without performing any photosynthesis. Okay, we call them as the scale leaves. So they are called as paraphysis. Okay, in between the antheridia, in this antheridial head, we can see the presence of these paraphysis. They are helping in providing the protection to these antheridia, and also they are helping in providing the food material to the developing antheridia. Okay, now when we talk about the antheridia, you can see this is an antheridial structure. They are elongated. You can see here. They are elongated, surrounded by a jacket layer of cells which are surrounding the central androecyte mother cells. Okay, so how the antheridia are developed? So we'll see that antheridial development here. So the antheridia, they just arise from the embryonic cell of the male shoot. So that means to say, within the apical bud, or we can say it as here, this is a tissue. So this is the antheridial head we are talking about. You can see the structure here. Okay, so this is the antheridial head. So in this antheridial head tissue, one of the cell, so that is the gametophytic tissue, whatever present here, one of the cell get differentiate as antheridial initial. Okay, now this initial, it will undergo many transverse and the longitudinal division and forming this androgonial cells. Okay, now so this is called as the embryonic cell, or we are calling it as the antheridial initial. Okay, so it increases in size and it undergoes transverse division to form one lower stalk cell and an upper antheridial mother cell. ఇవేంటి ఇది ఏం చెప్తున్నానేను ఎలా ఆంథ్రీడియా మనకి ఆంథ్రీడియల్ హెడ్ లో ఎలా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది అని చెప్తున్నాం అన్నమాట. ఓకే, సో ఆంథ్రీడియల్ ఇనీషియల్ ఫస్ట్ ఇట్ అన్నది ట్రాన్స్వర్స్ డివిజన్. ట్రాన్స్వర్స్ డివిజన్ అంటే ఒక అడ్డుకోత అనమాట. ఇట్లా ఫామ్ అయ్యి మనకి రెండు సెల్స్ లాగా ఫామ్ అవుతాయి. ఓకే, సో దీస్ టూ సెల్స్ లో లోవర్ సెల్ ని ఏమంటున్నాము స్టాక్ సెల్ అన్నాము, అప్పర్ సెల్ ని ఆంథ్రీడియల్ మదర్ సెల్ అన్నాము. సో these are the primary, the lowermost primary stalk cell, it will form the stalk, and the antheridial mother cell, it will divides to form an apical cell with two cutting faces. Ante enti ikkada, right? So you can children, okay, lowermost this will becomes the apical stalk cell, and the lowermost, and this is the upper antheridial mother cell. This antheridial mother cell, it will undergo dividing further and forming the apical cell, and the which undergoes still further divisions and forms the, okay, we'll go with this. So and form this 3 to 4, the apical cell will still further divide into forming the large cells, which we call it as 3 to 4 segments of the all the cells. So now this apical function, this cell functions as the operculum cell or the topmost cell of the anthidia. Now next forms the last segment. It divides by two vertical divisions and it forms a peripheral jacket initials and the central primary andragonial cells. So the jacket cells further divide to form a single layer jacket, and the primary andragonial cells, they divide to form the andragonial cells. Ante enti ikkada apical cell, it is still further dividing into many layers and segments on cheppan kada. So they are going to form the operculum cell and the surrounding jacket layer. And the primary andragonial cell, whatever you can see here, that is developed into the central mass tissue, which is called as the andragonial cells or andragonial mother cells or androcyte mother cells. So this androcyte's mother cells, they will further undergo division and produce the antheridia. So idi mottham kod anthrozoite, the male gamete, sorry. So this forms the antheridium structure. Stalk is there, the surrounding globose jacket layer is there, central androcyte mother cell, this together form the matured antheridium. Now in this antheridium, the central androcyte mother cell or the andragonial tissue, one of the androcyte mother cell will divide and produce the biflagellated antherozoids, which is the sperm or the male gamete of the antheridial head or the polytrichum. So ikkada chudandi, this is ee central lo kanapadevi enti, these are the paraphyses and these are the perichaetal leaves. Okay, these are the paraphyses which is providing the mechanical strength and food material to this antheridia. And from this antheridia, when it gets mature, we can see the antherozoid, the sperm, the biflagellated male gametes, they are just coming out from the that is the operculum or the lid or the whole operculum cell. From this antheridia, they are coming out. So this is how the structure of antheridial head and how the antheridia is developed in this antheridial head and how the antherozoids are formed. Now we'll go with the archegonial head, the female plant. So in the female plant also, the archegonia, they are developed on the apices or at the top of the leafy shoot. Okay, now these archegonia also, they are surrounded by the cluster of leaves, what we call them as the perichaetal leaves, and these archegonia occur in around 3 to 6. So in this cluster, that is in this archegonial head, there are around 3 to 6 archegonia developed. So when we talk about the archegonia, how it is a flask shaped structure, and the neck is very long here. This is a characteristic feature of the polytrichum. The archegonial neck is very long, made up of around 6 rows of neck canal cells. And in the base, you can see a venter with a small venter canal cell and an egg cell. Okay, so here you can't find any paraphyses. Just like in the antheridial head, we said the antheridia are alternated with the paraphyses in between. But in the archegonial head, you can't see any paraphyses between the archegonia. Only thing is, they are getting surrounded by the cluster of perichaetal leaves. Now, how the archegonia is developed? Similarly, just like the antheridia, how they are developed here also, one of the apical cell of the archegonial head will get transformed as an archegonial initial. So this archegonial initial this archegonial head, it also divides by one transverse division and forms two celled structure. One is the stalk cell and another one becomes the archegonial mother cell. Now this stalk cell, it will keep on dividing and dividing and forms the stalk of the archegonia, whereas the archegonial mother cell, or we can call it as archegonial main cell, it will undergo three vertical divisions. Okay, it undergo three vertical divisions and forms three peripheral surroundings of the cell. Okay, now three peripheral cells, they divide to form 2 to 3 layered of the jacket layer, and the axial cell, that is the one which is present at the topmost of this peripheral cell, it will divide transversely. So this is axial cell which will divide transversely and forms the inner central cell and the outer apical cell. So this is the central cell and the outer apical cell. Now this central cell will form a small, here you can see here, the central cell, this will form the small Venter canal cell and a long neck canal cell. Okay, now the apical cell divides further and forms this long neck, and the ventral canal cell is already developed, and lowermost of it will be the egg cell. Okay, so this neck canal cell is almost around 6 rows of cells, so due to which the archegonial neck appears very much long enough. Okay, and globose venter will have only one venter canal cell with a female egg cell. So this is how the archegonia is going to be developed from the single archegonial initial. Now after this, what is happening? Fertilization. Now the matured antheridia produces the anthrozoites, and the mature archegonia forms the egg cell. That means to say, when they get matured, at that time, due to the water drop, that is when the water splash on this, what we call it as the sexual organs, the water is retained by the antheridia and the archegonia, by which the sexual organs will help in the cleavage of the antheridia to release the anthrozoites from the antheridia or the from the antheridial head. Now, the Venter canal cell and the neck canal cells, they dissolve to form the mucilage in the archegonia. This mucilage will exert the pressure to open the neck. And then the neck of the archegonia open aipothe, the mucilage anta kuda baitikochi, archegonial head degara, this mucilage will attract the anthrozoites towards the egg or the towards the female gamete. Now one of the anthrozoites, it will go and fuses with the egg and it forms the zygote. So that is the diploid zygote, which is the next, the cell for the next generation, that is the sporophyte. Okay, now so how is the zygote? So the zygote, or we are also calling now it as the oospore. Now what is this oospore? This oospore divides transversely. Okay, and the zygote single cell, a single cell zygote will undergo one transverse division and form upper epibasal and lower hypobasal cell. The upper hypobasal, that is epibasal, and the lower hypobasal enti, they are the one which are going to develop the sporophyte. So how is a sporophyte? So hypobasal cell is going to form the foot and the seta, whereas the epibasal cell, it will going to form the capsule region of the sporophytic tissue. Now how is that, Anidhi? I'll show you with another PPT here. I'll develop. Wait a minute, ma'am. Oh, so I'm sharing the screen again. Just a minute. polytrichum capsule. So I'm just sharing the screen. So this PPT I'll end here. Okay, just I'll close this. So 1 second. Can you see the PPT girls here?
No, madam, no.
No, madam.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, madam, no, now it's sharing.
Now is it visible, sir?
Yes, yes.
1 second. Yeah. So this is the now the polytrichum sporophyte. That is after the division of the sporophyte, that is a zygote. The epibasal cell and the hypobasal cell, they are developing into the parts of the sporophyte. Okay, so this is a what do you call highly developed sporophyte or advanced developed sporophyte in the polytrichum. We can see the sporophyte highly evolved, emerging out of the gametophyte, and this is a very macroscopic character. We can see the structure very clearly on the plant body. Okay, now so this is sporophyte, just like the Marchantia and Anthoceros. Even this is also possess three characteristic features or the three parts. They are the foot, seta, and the capsule. So here we can see the foot, which is completely buried or present inside the gametophytic tissue. Okay, so here you can't see any foot region in this picture. Okay, it is completely buried. That means to say it is completely present inside the female plant, that is the antigonial head. We can see that in that particular plant. Now, so what is the role of this foot? Just like it is helping in attaching the sporophyte to the gametophyte, and it also helps in absorbing the water from the gametophytic tissue. Next comes to the next important region is the seta. So in this capsule region or in the sporophyte, the seta is several inches long. You can see when we talk about the picture of a polytrichum, you have seen a long stalk-like structure emerging out in the gametophyte. So that is the seta region. It is several inches long, and it carries this capsule in the air. Okay, so it appears just like a fruit, or it appears just like a cap plant structure la kanapadutundi gametophyte paina. Okay, so seta is very very long and having at the tip region a cap-like capsule. Okay, so what is the function of the seta? The seta, it helps in conducting of water and food from the gametophyte to the capsule region. Okay, so that is the main role of the seta. Now, next important point of the polytrichum is the capsule. So this is the capsule region here. So this capsule, it is differentiated into three regions. Now, what are those three regions? We can see here, this is the apophysis, theca, this is the theca, and the operculum, or we call it as the lid. I repeat, this is a very important mark. Capsule structure anedi very important in the polytrichum. I repeat this, the capsule is divided into three regions, apophysis, this is the theca and the operculum. Okay, now what is the apophysis? Now this apophysis is the lowermost part of the capsule. It is in continuation with the ceta and it is just appearing like a ring of protuberance at the base of the capsule. And here this apophysis, it consists of the photosynthetic, I repeat, this apophysis, it consists of loosely arranged parenchymatous photosynthetic tissue. That means these parenchyma cells, they store the chloroplast and it appears green in color and helping in preparation of the food material. Okay, so this apophysis is always supplying the food material to this developing theca region. Okay, now next comes to the theca. So what is it? It is a middle part of the capsule and it is four lobed. That means its wall is several layered, having the outer epidermis. So just I'll show you here the picture. So this is the theca, the central part of the capsule, what we call it as the theca region. When we talk about the theca, we can see here, this is the outermost thick epidermal wall layer. And below this epidermal wall layer, you can see the air space. You can see here, there is an empty air space. In between that empty air space, you can see here the two balloon-like structures. We call them as the sporogenous or the theca. They have the long thin walled cells. We call them as the sporogenous tissue or the theca. So this is the theca region. Okay, long sporogenous tissue. Okay, so surrounding that and empty air space lo, you can see this region, sporogenous tissue region. Okay, surrounding that you can see there are trabeculae. So ikkada meeku a shaped structures la kanapadthunnayi chudandi, surrounding the central sporogenous tissue. E this is a theca ante andulo sporogenous tissue untundi, or we call it as a spore sac also, bag laanti structures anamata. Ee bag lo manaki spores anetivi form avutayi. Okay, we call them as a spore sac. Surrounding the spore sac, they are the trabeculae. So what are these trabeculae? They are the cells which are helping the spore sac to give the mechanical strength. Ante spore sac ki etuvanti damage kaakunda undadaniki these trabecular cells are helping them, giving the protection. Not only the protection, and also they are hygroscopic in nature. Ante they can absorb the water and supply it to the spore sac for the dispersal, and also providing the mechanical strength. And spores are etuvanti damage kalakunda undadaniki they are just acting like a mechanical supporters, or they are just acting like a shock absorbers anamata. Ante sudden ga emaina damage avute these trabeculae they will provide the support, shock absorber. Mana bikes ki vaatiki shock absorbers untayi kada, ante manaku emaina emantaru రోడ్ పైన సడన్ గా ఏమైనా బ్రేక్ వేయాలనుకుంటే ద షాక్ అబ్జార్బర్స్ విల్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ us నాట్ టు ఫాల్ డౌన్. సో జస్ట్ లైక్ దట్ దీస్ ట్రాబెక్యులే దే విల్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ ద స్పోర్ సాక్ ఫర్ నాట్ టు గెట్ ఎనీ డామేజ్. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఇన్ ది థీకా రీజియన్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఇన్ ద సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ ది థీకా రీజియన్ యూ కెన్ సీ ఏ లాంగ్ కండక్టింగ్ స్ట్రాండ్ we call this as the columella, which is continuous right from the ceta to the tip of the capsule. That will be a continuous region providing the conduction of the food material and also the water supply. Okay, so this is the theca region, very very important. Okay, I'll repeat this once again here. Theca, this is the second region of the entire capsule, having surrounded by an epidermal layer. So below that you can see some hypodermis tissue or a parenchymatous tissue. In the central we can see the presence of two spore sacs, okay, in the eighth chamber. And these spore sacs, they are surrounded by the trabeculae, providing the mechanical support to this spore sac. And the spore sac internally, it consists of the sporogenous tissue and also having the spore sac wall. And the sporogenous tissue will undergo reduction, division and produce the spores. And the central region of the theca, consisting of the conducting strand, what we call it as the columella. So this is about the second region of the sporophyte, that is a seat, that is of the capsule, that is the theca. Now next we'll go for the third point, that is of the capsule region, we call it as the operculum. So operculum maintained, this is the uppermost part of the capsule, and it is, the shape of it is like a conical shape. It acts like a cap or a lid anamata. Ante manaki oka koojoki cap pedte etla untundi, it acts just like that, operculum. So this operculum, it is covered by calyptra, a protective or a hairy layer. So this is known as the hair moss. Due to the presence of this operculum, deeniki manaki hair moss or we also call it as a cap moss ani kuda deeniki oka peru. Now attaching the operculum with the theca, there is a rim or diaphragm. Okay, so meeku ikkada chudochu. So ikkada idantha kuda theca kada, theca region of the capsule. Ee theca ki idemo operculum having a conical shape. Okay, so this is getting attached to this theca at this a constriction point. This is called as the diaphragm, or we are calling it as a rim. Okay, so this is having, playing a role of just opening and closing of this operculum to this theca region. Next, so in this operculum or attached to, so or inner to the operculum, at the base of this constriction, we can see the presence of teeth like structures. అంటే పళ్ళు లాగా కనబడతాయి, దట్ వి కాల్ ఇట్ యాస్ పెరిస్టోమియల్ టీత్ ఆర్ పెరిస్ట్రోమ్. ఓకే, సో ఇవి ఎక్కడ ఉన్నాయి, ఇట్ ఇస్ ప్రెసెంట్ జస్ట్ బిలో ది డయాఫ్రామ్, వాట్ వి కాల్ ఇట్ యాస్ ఎఫిబ్రామ్. సో దిస్ పెరిస్టోమ్, ఇట్ దే ఆర్ వెరీ థిక్ హార్డ్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్. సో దే ఆర్ అటాచ్డ్ టు దిస్ ఇన్నర్ రింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది డయాఫ్రామ్. సో దే ప్లే ఎ రోల్, or we could a hygroscopic, they play a role in opening and closing or tight fixing of the operculum to the theca region. Cap correct ga fix avvali ante ee peristomial teeth and diaphragm, they play a very important role. And another important role is this peristomial teeth also, they help in easy dispersal of the spores from the theca region during the dispersion. Okay, they are also hygroscopic in nature, they absorb the water and they will swell and make the operculum or the lid to open. So this is regarding the operculum. So this is a very important question in the exam point of view. Poly, explain in detail about the polytrichum capsule. So capsule manaki ippudu varaku kuda ఇంత కాంప్లికేటెడ్ ఆర్ కాంప్లెక్స్ స్ట్రక్చర్ కనపడలేదు, ఆంథోసిరోస్ లో కానీ ఆర్ మార్కాన్షియాలో కానీ. పాలిట్రైకమ్, దిస్ ఇస్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ జెనీరా ఆఫ్ ది బ్రయోఫైట్, కాబట్టి హైలీ డెవలప్డ్ క్యాప్సూల్ అనేది కనపడుతుంది విత్ సో మెనీ పార్ట్స్, ఎపోఫైసిస్, థీకా అండ్ ది ఒపక్యులం. ఓకే, నా సో నా ఫ్రమ్ ద స్పోర్ సాక్, దట్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద థీకా రీజియన్, whenever the spores are matured, that is whenever the spores are formed, then the dispersal will occur. How the dispersal is happening, this is also very important. Now, the cells of the epibrium, that is regarding the peristomial teeth, they dry up, and due to that, it separates the operculum. Ante adi mottam dry ayipongane manaki operculum anedi open ayipothundi. Calipra will fall, that is the lid will fall, and all the peristomial teeth, they also dry up, and just exposing the theca region to the surrounding environment. Lid anedi udipothe manaki theca region anta kuda expose ayipothundi. Now the central region of the theca, that is the spores, will expose by complete disintegration of all the tissue of the theca, that is manaki trabeculae disintegrate ayipothundi, hypodermal tissue will get disintegrate except the spores, and the spore wall will disintegrate. Only the spores will lie in the center of the capsule. That's it. All the tissue, whatever there in the theca, they all just disintegrate. Ante mottam capsule anta kuda meeku dry aipothundi. Now the spores will come out through the pores and they are just dispersed into the air. Mottam dry aipoyi cap udipoyi spores anni kuda just oka splash laga meeku bayatiki vachestayi. Now how these spores are? These spores are yellow and they are uninucleate, surrounded by the outer layer exine, or we are calling it as exosporium, and the inner layer called as endosporium. So when the favorable conditions are returned,